It's been less than a week since Demon Hunter came out, resulting in one of the most overwhelming ladder experiences for everybody. Not only was Demon Hunter played at all ranks, it had arguably one of the strongest day one decks to have ever been seen in Hearthstone's history. This strength and amount of players playing Demon Hunter prompted the development team to take swift action and nerf not one, but four of the cards in Demon Hunter. Even after all of these initial nerfs, Demon Hunter remains to be a powerful class. We're going to be taking a look at one of the strongest and most popular versions of Demon Hunter being played right now, Tempo Demon Hunter. Before we dive into the deck, make sure to subscribe to the Tempo Storm Hearthstone YouTube channel for all the latest Hearthstone content. Now let's take a look at what Tempo Demon Hunter has to offer. Tempo Demon Hunter is a very aggressive version that relies on the use of Demon Hunter's flexible hero power and strong minions to snowball out of control. It is almost reminiscent of Tempo Rogue. They both fight for board early and have quite a bit of burst damage towards the end of the game to help them get over the edge. One of the current lists featured still runs all four of the cards that were most recently nerfed by Blizzard. Although they have become significantly weaker than what they previously were, they are still insanely powerful. The combination of all of these powerful cards still makes for a very strong deck. In the early game, Demon Hunter uses its two weapons, Umberwing and Aldrachi Warblades, alongside the one mana hero power to control the board so that their early game minions like Battlefiend and Crimson Sigil Runner can get some nice chip damage in. Tools like I-Beam can also be used early on to make sure they don't fall too far behind. The amount of lifesteal that Demon Hunter has access to in the early game really makes sure that they can't die too fast to any other aggressive strategies. On the topic of not dying, Demon Hunter has some crazy removal tools. Both Altruist the Outcast and Blade Dance can help Demon Hunter clear any aggressive boards their opponent can make. It's very difficult for this version of Demon Hunter to lose the board in the early game. They generate so much efficiency from their powerful early weapons and removal tools. I mean, look at Umberwing, it's literally muster for battle for 2 mana. Oh, and Blade Dance coupled with some Twin Strikes can clear massive boards. That's just crazy. Once the game transitions into the middle stages, Demon Hunter has some powerful demons and synergies. Raging Fellscreamer allows for you to play Priestess of Fury on turn 5. Let that sink in. A 5 mana 6-7 that deals 6 damage randomly to all enemies at the end of each turn. Alongside Priestess of Fury, Imprisoned Antian can push quite a bit of damage. Not only can it clear boards your opponent plays, against slower decks, it's almost like a guaranteed pyroblast to their face. If you haven't already ended the game with the sheer power of Demon Hunter's early game, Priestess of Fury and Imprisoned Antian will make sure to close the game out. Let's just say all of that isn't enough for you either. Demon Hunter has more burst damage in the form of Metamorphosis. This legendary spell allows you to do 10 damage worth of hero powers over the course of 2 turns. Metamorphosis also helps get that final bit of reach even through a taunt minion. If you really don't like taunt minions, some lists have incorporated Kane's Sunfury, allowing for you to push massive amounts of damage even through taunt minions. Plus, a 4 mana 3-5 with charge is just a solid card by itself. Another great thing Demon Hunter has going for it is that it can truly just keep going. Skull of Gul'dan, Crimson Sigil Runner, Chaos Strike, and even sometimes Spectral Sight just allow Demon Hunter to seemingly never run out of steam. When they're ever drawing off of the top, drawing one of these cards can lead to a huge chain of draw, especially Skull of Gul'dan. Skull of Gul'dan single-handedly can take you from having nothing to a board that you probably shouldn't have. Demon Hunter will most likely undergo more nerfs in the future. Even after 4 of their cards were nerfed, the class still seems to be extremely strong. The development team has mentioned that they are still taking a look at Demon Hunter and will do what is necessary to make sure it doesn't get too out of hand. Tempo Demon Hunter is currently one of the strongest decks on ladder. Its combination of efficient tempo swings and powerful minions creates one of the strongest decks to come to Hearthstone. The development team will most likely need to address some more Demon Hunter cards in the near future to help make sure Demon Hunter isn't the only class seen on ladder. As for now, enjoy playing the arguably best class in Hearthstone at this current point in time. Do you think Tempo Demon Hunter is the best deck right now? Leave a comment down below. Also, make sure to like this video and subscribe to the Tempo Storm Hearthstone YouTube channel for all the best and latest Hearthstone content.